Back to some news from Parliament. The controversy in Amblypitiya was also brought up in Parliament today.
Over the past, we witnessed how persons were killed when they were escorted to show hidden weapons and when they were to be arrested. This was a culture. The allegations made by the locals against the police over this death must be taken into consideration. We recall how commissions were established over previous deaths. When we called for those commission reports to be tabled,
former Supreme Court Judge Sarat Deabru, who was charged with sexual assault, was released on bail today when the case pertaining to this matter was taken up before the Colombo High Court.
Colombo High Court Judge Preeti Padmasirisena ordered that Sarat Deabru be released on a cash bail of 100,000 rupees and a surety bail of 200,000 rupees. The court ordered that the case be taken up for hearing again on the 23rd of May. The former Supreme Court judge pleaded not guilty to the charge filed against him.
He provided a statement for 3 hours. I was present as well. He provided the addresses, contact numbers of the witnesses. The police did not take those into their investigation. That is how the indictment was filed. I say it is illegal.
After being granted bail, the former justice left the court complex without signing the respective documents and returned to court once again to sign them.
Have we forgotten?
Several law enforcement agencies conduct investigations into Sajin Ras Gunawardena. An unlicensed elephant calf worth 10 million rupees found at the former MP's residence. Failure to make payments due to the government with regard to civil aviation operations of the aviation company allegedly owned by Sajin Divas Gunawardena. Alleged financial irregularities at the flight school said to be owned by Sajin Divas Gunawardena. Misuse of 22 vehicles belonging to the presidential secretariat. These are just a few of the allegations. Sajin Divas Gunawardena was summoned to the commission to investigate allegations of bribery or corruption on several occasions. The commission suspended the former MP's passport for 3 months on the 22nd of January 2015. Sajin Divas Gunawardena was arrested and remanded for the misuse of vehicles belonging to the presidential secretariat. He was granted bail on the 23rd of August last year by the Colombo High Court.
Sajin Divas Gunawardena, who is now a state's witness, has been provided SAF security and vehicles. We ask whether this is what was promised to the people of the country. What was said is that the money that was stolen from them would be returned. It does not seem that this is taking place. In the lapse of 1 year, this group is doing things that are on par with what the previous family did. The law needs to be enforced with regard to public property that was stolen, and the faith of the people that the law will be enforced needs to be re-established.
Neethiya kriyaatmak kirime pilibanda viswasaya janathawata hadanna one ema naththam
have we forgotten.